Here we're going to divide polynomials, and we're going to break this up into what we call, well, two cases. And case one is when the denominator is a monomial. So this is an example of case one, and I can see the denominator here is a monomial. Now remember, a monomial is simply a polynomial with only one term. Okay, and then when you have the situation, what you simply do is you take all the terms in the numerator and you divide them individually by the denominator. Okay, so it's going to be this divided by that, and then this divided by that, and then this divided by that. So you write it out. Let's see, what do we get? Well, 12x to the fourth y cubed over 3x squared y squared. Okay, and the next one's going to be minus 6x squared y squared over 3x squared y squared. And then finally, it's going to be plus 18xy divided by that denominator, 3x squared y squared, okay? So they all individually get divided by that common, or by that single denominator. And then once you've done that, you simply divide these. So, you know, 3 goes into 12 four times. And I'm also left, you know, x to the fourth divided by x squared is x squared. And y cubed over y is y. And there, you know, you could write this as over 1, but we typically don't. So 4x squared y for that one, and then minus, well, it's going to be just 2, because 3 goes into 6 twice, and x squareds, those cancel, the y squareds cancel. And for the last one, well, we're going to have a 6 in the numerator, but in the denominator, well, I'm going to have an extra x, because x over x squared is going to leave me an x here, and for the same reason, I'm going to have a y in the denominator. Once I take y and divide it by y squared. And this would be my answer. This is as far as I can go. So basically, when you have a monomial in the denominator, you simply divide term by term. Okay, what about the other situation, the other case, case two? Okay, so case two is when the denominator is not a monomial. So I would like to first consider with you a situation. So let me write first, I'd like you to consider something you already know how to do. So consider long division. And we're going to need this for what we talk about in a second. So, you know, if somebody gave you, 2564, let's say, divided by 7, to perform long division, what you do is you take the 7, which is called the divisor, and write it off to the side, and then you'd create this little fraction bar, and then under the little bar you'd write the dividend, 2564. And as usual, you know, 7 goes into 25, it goes in 3 times. And what you then do is you multiply 3 and 7 together to get 21, and then you subtract that off. Now, a couple things. First of all, notice how when you find the number here, what you do is you multiply it by whatever's there, and then you put the result here. Then you subtract off that number. Now it looks like you're subtracting 21, right? But you're not. And the reason is because look where 21 is located. It's actually 2100. Nobody really writes the zeros here. But when you do this, when you say, you know, 5 take away 1 and you write a 4, what you're doing is acknowledging that 2564, when you take away 2100, you're really left with, and you write a 46, but you really, don't forget, you really have that 4 there as well. So what you're really doing is saying 2564 take away 2100, and that leaves you with 464. Now, of course, we just write the 46 because that's how it goes with long division, but we're going to be doing this soon with polynomials, and we want to keep this in mind. All right, so 7 goes into 46. It's going to be 6 times. And then you multiply the 6 by the 7, and you get a 42. And then you subtract that 42 off, and then it's going to be a 4. Bring down this 4, and now you have a 4 here. And by the way, in this step, it looked like you subtracted 42, but you didn't. You really subtracted 420 from 464, and you're left with 44. And then 7 goes into 44 6 times, so you have 42. And now you have a 2 remainder, your remainder is a 2. So your answer would be, in this case, 366 plus the remainder, which is 2, divided by the divisor, which is 7. Now, nobody writes that. We simply write 366 and 2/7. So this is typically how you write your answer. But just keep in mind that this is really how we're going to be writing things with polynomials, okay? All right, so we'll go ahead and with that in mind, we're going to handle case 2 when we're dividing two polynomials, but the denominator is not a monomial. And we're going to use what's called long division, but for polynomials. Okay, so we're going to divide 5x to the 4th minus x squared minus x plus 2. We're dividing that by x squared minus 2x. So, first of all, the denominator is not a monomial. So we're not in case 1. So once you acknowledge that, then you use what's called long division. So it's long division for polynomials, the way, you know, we just had long division for numbers, now long division for polynomials. Okay, and here's how it works. You take the divisor, the x squared minus 2x, and once again, you write it on the outside. And likewise, you create your little fraction symbol, and you write the dividend in that little space there. When I look at this dividend, do you see how the exponents go from 4 to 2 to 1 and then the constant term? Notice how I skipped the number 3, right? There's nothing here with x cubed. It's like a term is missing. Whenever you are writing or, you know, looking at your terms in descending order like this, where the exponents are descending, and you see that something's missing, 4, 3, 2, 1, we're going to write a 0 for the term that's missing. So I'm going to write this. 5x to the 4th plus 0x cubed. You might say, how can I write that? Well, 0 times x cubed is just 0, so it's like writing a plus 0 in there, which doesn't change anything. But it's going to be important for, this is going to act as a space holder, as we're going to see in a moment. And then you continue down. You have minus x squared, minus x, and then finally plus 2. That's how it's going to go for these problems. We are going to write both the divisor, which is on the outside here. We're going to write that polynomial in descending order, and same with the dividend. So all the exponents are decreasing from left to right. And if any terms are missing, you have to write a 0 times x to whatever exponent is missing. All right, so here's what we do. You look at the leading term of your divisor, which is this x squared here, right? And what you do is you ask yourself, what do you have to multiply the x squared by to get the leading term of the dividend? So in other words, what do you multiply x squared by to get 5x to the 4th? Do you see that x squared multiplied by 5x squared? Do you see how that's going to give me 5x to the 4th? For that reason, right, so what I did is I just discovered the 5x squared. You take that 5x squared and you write it above the corresponding term in the dividend. So I'm going to write the 5x squared here because it's raised to the second power, and that's raised to the second power as well. So what I did is I asked myself, let me just recap with you. I asked myself, what do I need to multiply just the x squared by to get 5x to the 4th? And once I found that, I wrote that above the term that it corresponds to. Okay, now remember when you did long division a moment ago with numbers, you took whatever number was here and you multiplied it by whatever is there. But of course with numbers it was easy, right? It was that number times this number. But with polynomials, in this case, do you see how this is a binomial? There are two terms. I'm going to have to take that 5x squared and distribute it. So 5x squared times x squared, that gives me the 5x to the 4th. Okay, and then 5x squared gets multiplied by negative 2x as well. And that's going to be a negative 10x to the 3rd. And I want to write it below the term that corresponds to it. And now you can see why I put the 0x cubed in here, so that these terms line up vertically. So if you recall what we did once we had the number here, we simply subtracted it from what we had up there. So because this is a binomial here, what we do is we want to subtract it off, but we want to subtract off the whole thing. So you put parentheses around it like so, and then subtract it off. Okay, and that's always how it's going to go. You're going to take this, multiply it by whatever's there. That gives you something here. put parentheses around it, and subtract it off. Okay, and once you do that, what do we get? Well, let's see. Imagine this negative being distributed. So 5x to the fourth, take away 5x to the fourth, there's 0x to the fourth, so you don't have to write that. As far as x cubes or the x cubed terms are concerned, 0x cubed, now negative times a negative is a positive 10x cubed, and positive 10x cubed plus 0x cubed is positive 10x cubed. And then you still have the rest of this. Now with long division with numbers, you simply brought down the next number. With polynomials, you bring everything down. So minus x squared minus x plus 2. And then you keep going. You play the same game again. X squared times what, in this case, gives the leading term. So what do you have to multiply the x squared by to get 10x cubed? That's going to be positive 10x. So you put the positive 10x here, plus 10x. And then you have to take that positive 10x and distribute it. So 10x times x squared is going to be 10x cubed. And then positive 10x times negative 2x is going to be negative 20x squared. Okay, and then you want to put parentheses around that and subtract off the whole thing just like you did before. So 10x cubed, take away 10x cubed is 0x cubed. That's the whole point. Negative x squared. Now the negative times a negative is a positive, right? So positive 20x squared, take away 1x squared, is 19x squared, and you still have minus x and plus 2. Now you ask yourself, what do you multiply x squared by to get 19x squared, and the answer is positive 19, so it goes plus 19, and then you take that positive 19 and distribute it, so it's going to be 19x squared minus 38x, because positive 19 times negative 2x gave negative 38x, put that in parentheses, subtract off the whole thing. So the 19x squared minus 19x squared is 0x squared. Negative x plus 38x, that's 37x, and then plus 2. Now something really interesting happens here. When you now look at this x squared, and you say to yourself, what do you multiply that by to get this? There is no polynomial that you multiply this by to get that 37x. And the reason, of course, is because this is x to the first, but your divisor is x to the second. So whenever, you know, with numbers, whenever the remainder is smaller than the number, than the divisor, that's when you stop. And the same thing happens here. Whenever the remainder, which is a polynomial, is smaller than the divisor, you stop. But by smaller, we mean that this is of a smaller degree than the divisor. Okay, so this hit x to the first, so this polynomial is smaller than that, so the game is over. So my answer, just like before, is my quotient plus my remainder over to my divisor. So this would be my answer. 5x squared plus 10x plus 19, right? That's my quotient. And then plus my remainder, which is 37x plus 2. Divided by my divisor, which is x squared minus 2x. Okay, that whole thing is my answer. Like before, you know, you had a number plus remainder over divisor. Same thing is happening here, but instead of numbers, it's polynomials. Polynomial plus polynomial over polynomial. Okay, so all of this whole thing is your answer. Okay, so we see that when you're dividing polynomials, there are two cases. And when the denominator is not a monomial, that is when there's more than one term here, you have to use what we call long division. Okay, until next time.